If you would like to get your song reviewed, dear listener, there's the Filthy Capitalist option. It sorry says 125 gets you straight to the head of the line. You don't have to be a part of the alliance. You don't have to be part of the group.
Wait a minute.
And the biggest thing is you don't have to wait. You hop, skip, and jump right in front of everybody. 125 gets you there. You do that 3 times and then get mashed down to the $75 rate for perpetuity.
Yes.
Also, there is a band review option. So if you've got a band and you're trying to get your band some exposure, hit me up at insori@gmail.com and I'll show you the details about how to pull
you
that off.
You can also jump on Patreon and there is a option on the tiers to be able to get your band reviewed. Yep. Obviously, we can't lie to you, so we can't guarantee a positive review. Get what you get.
It's just rubbish.
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 That's British for garbage.
My favorite is the community option. $1 at the gate gets you in a Patreon. You get to join an alliance. The alliance joins their points together, and that helps determine what songs that we do.
The alliances hang out on Discord.
Message me on Patreon to get the link.
And they do all kinds of other cool things. They do Minecraft. Dungeons and Dragons.
Yeah. It's really a community within the community. Anybody can go in the village, facebook.com/vinandsori. There's 160,000+ people on the channel. What's cool about the Discord is that it offers a real opportunity for community, connection, friendship, that type of thing.
But, and it's on Discord, so if you're not a Facebook person, it's for you.
You start off at $1.
Right.
Plus you get exclusives. Sori and I are working on a song. So the first 15 seconds of that was on Patreon. Also, at $15 tier and above, when we actually debut the video, they're going to be there live with us. There you are, dear listener.
Buy our merch.
Buy our merch indeed. A child shall lead them.
To buy our merch.
Yes, dear listener. This is the band, The Tragically Hip. The name of the song is...
Poets.
Yes. Actually...
This is for the big homie James.
This band actually commented on our reaction.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I forgot the name of their song. It was their more popular song. And it was their most popular song. I asked if we got something right, but I never went back to check to see what the response. We are so terrible the way we are with these people. But shout out to that band and shout out to the band for watching the review. That was pretty crazy. Okay. This is for the big homie, James. You know the deal. He gets straight to the head of the line. This is not a DJ stream. This is not an alliance night. This is for you, dear listener, the Ronin.
Yes.
The Gaia. You shelled out your 125 or your 75, and now you've been pushed to the top of the list on a day you haven't even been scheduled.
So here you are.
Here you are.
And here
All
we
right,
are.
The Tragically Hit Poets. Let's do this.
Let's go.
Trying to get the lyrics. Sorry, restart it. Why can't people see us?
Oh no.
There we go.
We've right. returned.
We'll do that again. Just, this is what I get for trying to get the lyrics after the download.
Starts when a heartbeat's pounding, when
Amazon account is up and running now. We are selling our formula officially. It's amazing stuff from Europe.
Made in Germany. Sold in America.
Highest standards there are. In America, the standards haven't been updated since 1980. It's super weird, like older than me. In Europe, they update safety standards basically every year. This formula is top notch, great for the stomach, great for constipation. This is a great product. If you happen to want to purchase it and join us on our journey, then grab the link in the description. If you do and leave a review for us, send me a screenshot at vinandstory@gmail.com of your review after you have received the product. We will put your name in a hat. Song reviews are going to come out by some of the people that have left reviews. Don't forget to send us a screenshot of your review once you get the product. Now a word from our mascot dressed as a pirate, Fuji.
It's a steal of a deal.
That was
tragically hip poets. Wow, what a
sonically.
Okay,
I really enjoyed the instrumentation.
Did
go ahead.
It feel hip to you?
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I feel like
people
music...
mentioned the Rolling Stones. It had that kind of Rolling Stones energy. Yeah, I agree with the Rolling Stones.
Yeah,
energy
I think
for sure.
That I think when you hear the sound hip and when people would describe it as. Back in the day. This, to me, fits the description. I think that that's very interesting. Maybe they were inspired by their own name. Yeah, I like this.
What did you think the song was about?
What year did this come down?
What year did this come out?
98?
Okay. Yeah, I felt like they were
not what I would have guessed.
I think they were critiquing like the music industry or something like that. I think they were basically saying that all of the like the now popular bands are like full of it. Basically, is what it sounds like he was trying to say, which is kind of interesting. That's why when he mentioned like porn, I'm like,
yeah,
is that like a low key dig at corn?
Yeah,
because he says
I'm like, what is happening?
He says there's splintered legions, the withered corn stalks in them winter regions. See that corn stalks?
Yeah.
I'm like, these guys are obviously very intelligent. So I'm like, yo, could that have been, you know, a real diss at you know, whatever? So I was like, holy shit, okay. These guys are going for everybody's head, which I would have liked. Like, if that's what they were doing, like, if that's really what they were doing, that would be, like, so gangster to me.
Yeah,
because 50 Cent, like, one of his first songs was, I don't even know if most 50 Cent fans know this on this side of the world, but he came out with this song, this freestyle called How to Rob.
Okay.
And in that song, he just started dissing everybody, like... Wu-Tang Clan, he's gonna rob Jay-Z, he's gonna rob Lil' Kim, he's gonna rob every... He's like, I'm robbing all you guys.
How did that go over?
Well, I mean, obviously, at the time, all of us were like, oh my God, because nobody's ever done this.
Yeah.
Big and Pac had already gotten killed. So I'm like, so we were like, holy shit, I can't believe he did that. And it's like, where's he gonna go? Because all these, like, if you diss Biggie and Jay, that's Brooklyn.
So there's still somewhere else
you say you're going to rob Fat Joe. Fat Joe is like literally in with the mafia. He's from the Bronx. That's from where I'm from. Wu-Tang, they got the entire Shaolin. Like,
yeah.
It was,
but, so what happened?
I mean, obviously he made out with his life. But, you know, but 50 was also like a real life street gangster. I mean, he was in the shit.
Oh, really?
Yeah, 50 was a real gangster. So... But anyway,
is he the one selling music to white people? Like it made it all the way up to Maine?
Yeah. These people going crazy with this mayonnaise shit. Fuck all you people in the mayonnaise shit. Damn you, Cassia Bell. No, but my point is, like, I think he's like going after every like all the popular bands right now, is what it looks like to me. But I don't have enough context, because in 1998, like, that was a little bit before my time. I didn't get converted
to metal until
Woodstock. Actually, Woodstock 99, actually. So it would have been the next year. So I was out of the game. Some final accounting. Lava flowing in a super farmer's direction. He's been getting reprieve from the heat in the frozen food section. So that's talking about, I think, how capitalism is, like, screwing with the farming industry.
Yeah.
Don't tell me what the poets are doing. Don't tell me they're dark and tough. Don't tell me they're antisocial. They're not antisocial enough. So that tells me it's like, maybe if you're in one of these bands, like maybe a Rage Against the Machine type fan, mm-hmm. and like you think the band is like really progressive or whatever, but at the end of the day, like they're not really doing anything. Like what have they actually done to stop anything? So they're singing all this like political stuff,
yeah.
But what are they really, you know, accomplishing? See what I'm saying? So don't tell me what the poets are doing. Don't tell me that they're talking tough. Don't tell me they're antisocial. They're not antisocial enough.
Like, see what I'm saying? Okay. Well, at the end of the day, what does he want them doing?
Well, I don't know. Like, maybe this is like, you know, the older generation generally, you know, they always got something to say, negative to say about the current generation's musical. You see what I'm saying?
Expression.
Like, you know, it's like a back in my day type of situation. Yeah. Uh-huh. So, and the other thing too is like, especially if they were critiquing nu metal, which 1998 was pretty much the epitome of nu metal. I mean, that's why Korn and Limp Bizkit were able to go to Woodstock 99.
Yeah.
So if you were critiquing nu metal, I think a lot of the bands had a problem with nu metal because now you see how easy it is to play.
Yeah.
Like, it's so easy. Like, I have a hard time sticking to like a nu metal song. Like, you see what I'm saying? Yeah. So can you imagine, like, you're working on your craft, and then all of a sudden these kids start showing up
with
the drop D tuning.
That would be so frustrating.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah. So, you'd lose a lot of hope in that generation. You'd that's be like, what I'm are saying. You serious?
But that's why he says, like, don't tell me what the poets are, these Himalayas of the mind. You know, like, Himalaya is, like, the world's highest mountains.
Yeah.
Like, you know, like, these guys are, that's sarcastic, I think he's saying. They're not very deep thinkers.
Okay.
Like, you know, it's a molehill. They're not, but they think they're deeper than they really are, I think is what he's trying to tell. So I think that's what he's talking about. It's like the commercialization of music. You know, it's not about mastering your craft anymore. It's not about mastering the English language anymore. You know, why do you even bother? You know, he said with such wide and tentative swipes, and everybody's going after their archetypical father, you know, which is sort of a recycled, you know, at the end of the day, like, that's pretty much all teenage rebellion is. All of commercialized teenage rebellion is really just rebellion against your dad.
Right.
Because, you know, and that's fine. Like, even if you want to, like, conglomerize that as the government, 99% of the time when people are talking about the government in a way that you need to rebel against, the government is always personified as a man. Like, for example, the man.
Right.
You know, like in the 70s, like, the man keeping me down. It was Uncle Sam, whatever, whatever. You know, nobody ever says that Lady Liberty is oppressing them.
Right.
So, like, a lot of teenage rebellion and that you get, that rock and roll kind of swoops in and cashes in on that spirit of rebellion, it's really against a male archetype. Mm-hmm. Whether it's your dad, the government, God, like Behemoth, like that entire genre, like you could say you're mocking him, you could say whatever you want, but at the end of the day, God is still the center of your band. Like, where would Nergal be without God to attack, right?
Right.
Well, that's a male, that's an archetypical male figure, right? And if you're against the government, great, that's also an archetypical male figure.
Right.
And if you're rebelling against your family, most of the time it's you're rebelling against your dad. So he's saying, like, oh, great, let's cash in on rebellion. Like, oh, wow, we've never seen this before. Like, oh, let me guess, you're mad at the system or whatever, whatever.
Right,
like,
right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, and now, especially now in the woke era, like, this shit is on crack now. Like, so now everything is archetypically male and bad. And the patriarchy, damn it!
Right, wow.
So, like, all these things are just recycled tropes that get, you know, repackaged and used over and over again. But it's funny to me because the teenagers really believe they figured something out. Like, I thought the shit was new. Don't you remember, like, being a teenager and you're like, hell yeah, I'm gonna put on this nail polish, bitch. I don't care how none of you feel. I'm putting on this nail polish in this bitch. Oh, shit, Columbine just happened. Great, we're all gonna go out and buy trench coats. That literally happened. I'm trying to find our trench coat mafia days. I probably shouldn't say that with a smile on my face, but that's how it was. It was just about a lot of rebellion, a lot of anger.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I get what he's saying there. Like, I do think it's hard to make it in the music industry, but I also think it's easy. Like, once you've made it, I think it's criminally easy to maintain, to write on that, because mm-hmm. it's really not difficult. You're writing about the same things that there ain't, like, especially during the nu metal era, there was literally an album with 10 songs. Two of them would be good. You'd throw away the rest. Like, there were 3-minute songs, so yeah. the band wasn't really invested. It was a half an hour of content.
Yeah.
I mean, honestly, it's insane.
Yeah.
It's absolutely insane.
You know, the first time I bought a CD and that happened, I thought that there was something wrong with me. I was like, wow, all this, and the only song, I only like one of their songs. I didn't realize it was like what you just said. Like, they only put effort into that one.
Yeah.
And expected everybody to buy 100%. That CD off the one.
100%. That you had, that they had it down to a formula. Yeah. You were going to get 2 songs that were going to hit the radio.
Yep.
Yep. And it's going to be within 3 minutes. Okay. 3:15 longest. Okay. And the rest of the songs were just going to be cheese. And then they would just go on tour. They would go on tour, and then there would be like 500 bands on the bill because all the songs are 3 minutes long, and only people only came for 2 or 3 songs anyway. So like, you'd have 558 bands on the bill and shit.
That's silly.
Yeah. That was the nu metal era.
Wow.
That's what it was. So I can imagine, like, this band, by this time, like, they had to open for some of these nu metal bands. You know what I'm saying? They had to open for them. So it's like, they saw the crowd of teenage kids be like, "You suck," wearing the corn shirt and shit, and then they're seeing good old Brian just chomping down on that low end for half an hour.
Stop.
Like, we heard that riff before. Yeah. Yes, this is the fifth time you've heard. But the crowd's still jumping like they never heard this shit before. That's right. There you are, being all intellectual and shit with your lyrics and fucking intricate with your song arrangements. You don't care about that. It's 98, bitch. We want 2 chords in this bitch. We want 4 chords.
Wow. Oh, man.
Hell no, Cassie, I'm not forgiving you. Hell no, I'm going to vote against you in your doctoral dissertation.
Oh, what happened?
I'm going to stop her from all the good she's attempting to do in the fucking planet just because of this one little personal vendetta.
Did she say something about mayonnaise?
Of course she did. And then she led all the other people into her rebellion and sin.
Go ahead. Whatever happens to you, it's your fault. You're on your own. this is a very interesting song. I definitely would not have put it in 98. I don't know.
Really?
No. I just, 98 was like so close to 2000, and 2000 feels like it wasn't as far away as it is.
Yeah, 2000. It's just a little bit. It was over 20 years ago.
It was just recognizing the year. I'd give this one a solid 9.1. What about you?
This is a 8.9 for me.
Pretty close.
I liked it. I hope I was close. I'm going to have to go back and look at the lyrics again. Maybe he was going after everybody in the music industry, or maybe that had nothing to do with it. I have no idea. What I do know is we have one more song for you beautiful people.
So we'll be right back.
We will be right back. Vin out.
Sorry out.
Gone.